So today we will discuss a specific topic in the strain energy method, which is the Castigliano's theorem. Castigliano's has proposed two theorems, which is Castigliano's theorem 1 and 2, and let us discuss in detail. So if we apply a load F1 and F2 on a simply supported beam like this, which we have discussed in the Maxwell's equation, we know how the deflection is going to happen. It is being denoted by the dotted line, right? So when we apply F1 and F2, we can say that the deflection at 1 has got two parts. One is x11 and second one is x12, where x11 is caused due to the load 1 and x12 is caused due to the load 2. Similarly, we have two displacements at the location 2. One is x21 and second one is x22. So altogether I can write that x1 is equal to x11 plus x12 and x22 is equal to x22 plus x21. And in Maxwell's relation we learned that α12 is equal to α21, and if we introduce this α21 in and α12 in this equation, I can rewrite the equation as x1 is equal to α11 f1 plus α12 f2. Similarly, I can rewrite the equation x2 as α22 f2 plus α21 f1. So this is one of the same. Now, what does Castigliano's theorem states? It states that if we differentiate the strain energy equation with respect to a particular load, say the load F1, then you are going to get the deflection at 1. That means if I whatever might be the variable upon which we are going to differentiate, we are going to get the deflection at that particular point. That means the partial derivative of the strain energy in a structure with respect to one of the external load acting on the structure is equal to the displacement at that force. That's very important. If you differentiate with F1, you are going to get X1. If you differentiate with respect to F2, you are going to get X2. Right? So this, instead of delta, I will rewrite this equation as Xi. Right? And we know we have derived the general expression for U as half into α11 f1 square plus α12 f1 f2 plus half into α22 f2 square. This was the general expression that we have derived for the Maxwell's equation, right? Say this is equation A. Now let's differentiate this A with respect to the load F1, because I'm interested, as per the theorem it says that if I differentiate this equation with respect to F1, I should get the value of X1. Let's see whether we will get it or not. So if you differentiate, it is going to be 1 by 2 into α11 into 2 F1 plus α12 into F2 plus 0, because you don't have an F1 term in the last term, so that's going to act as a constant, thereby the value is differential is 0, and the differential of f1 is going to be 1, and f1 square is going to be 2f1, right? And if we cancel out the terms, what we are going to left with is α11 f1 plus α12 f2, right? If you look this equation and this equation, we can say that which is equal to x1, right? So we have validated that dou u by dou fy is nothing but xi. This is the Castigliano's theorem, where the differential of a strain energy is going to, with respect to a load, is going to give you the deflection at that particular location. So how can we solve a problem using this concept? That is next question. The answer is very simple. First of all, you have to derive a general equation for the strain, which consists of all the forces in the system. You should not miss out any forces. All the forces should be included in the equation, and using that equation, you use that equation to differentiate with respect to some particular law to get the deflection at that location. That's how. That's easy. Okay, so keep that in your mind. And Castigliano's second theorem. Let's say, so the first theorem, he stated that dou u by dou p is equal to dou pi is equal to xi, or in other words, dou u by dou fi is equal to xi. This is one theorem. And just opposite to this, he has also derived that, stated that if you differentiate the load, the strain energy with respect to a deflection, you are going to get the value of load out there. This is the another Castigliano's theorem. So if I differentiate dou u by dou x1, it is going to give you f1, or if you differentiate dou u by dou x2, we are going to get f2. Right? Generally, we use this equation, dou u by dou f is going to give you x, to find out the deflection, because we will be focusing on that area and we have to solve some questions regarding the using the Castigliano's theorem 1. Right, so differentiating. So first of all, we have to formulate a strain energy equation, then we have to differentiate with respect to a law to give the deflection at that particular location. So that's all for today's session. Bye bye.